Hey guys,
my name is Koyanche and welcome to episode 10 of my Applied Energistics 2 tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So as you recall, last episode we started talking about the point-to-point system in Applied Energistics 2, also known as P2P, and in this episode I will specifically be talking about the ME P2P tunnels. So let's get started. So like I showcased last episode, the P2P tunnels pretty much allow you to connect one point from your ME network to another point. This is already quite useful with things like light, fluids, energy, and all that stuff that I showed last episode. But you might be asking, okay, but how does it exactly work with ME cables? Well, that is a good question, and on its own it might not seem like it has a lot of function, but if you look more in depth into it, it is absolutely awesome, and I use this a lot. So, for this demonstration, I got myself pretty much two ME networks set up. One which is marked by the red line, and one which is marked by the light blue line. Of course, I got myself an ME controller connected to this, even though it's not really necessary as I'm using less than 8 channels, but of course, for consistency's sake, I'm using it right here. On the blue line, I got myself an ME crafting terminal and an ME drive, just so I can actually access items that are put into the crafting terminal and are put into the drive, as you can see, like so. Pretty cool. The cool thing about these ME P2P tunnels on its own is that it allows you to pretty much pass through a Applied Energistics 2 network. Pretty much meaning that, as you can see, I got myself a blue ME network set up right here. Just, you know, for a demonstration purpose, I dyed it this color, so you guys can pretty much see what I mean by that. And I got myself another ME crafting terminal and an ME drive set up right here. Pretty much meaning that whatever I put in this one will be put into this ME drive. So this is a totally different network, not connected to this one in any way. And it also means that the red one is not able to actually access what the contents is in that ME drive, though the blue one is. That's already pretty cool. What makes it even cooler is that I'm using this main network to actually pass through the power that I'm using thanks to a creative energy cell under the ME controller, to pass through from this main network into the, well, I guess you can call it a sub-network or pass-through network, whatever you prefer, using this quartz fiber cable. Quartz fiber are another type of cables in Applied Energistics 2 that only transfer power. So simply put it on the side that actually has power, or the other side, it doesn't really matter that much. And then just connect some regular cables to this, pretty much meaning that it will only give the power from this network to this one, but won't actually send any channels, which is, using a subnetwork, most of the time exactly what you want to have. Only sending power from this place to this place and not the other way around. Of course, you can also hook this up to a separate power line using a different ME controller or a energy acceptor, but this is quite a lot, faster and cheaper too if you don't need to make another ME controller. Though keep in mind that you can only hook up these quartz fiber, I believe, to regular cables or smart cables, so not dense cables. So that kind of limits the amount of channels that you can send through at a same time, but still pretty cool. Then next up is the little bit more advanced stage, which I made right here, which is something I use in pretty much all my Applied Energistics networks, but it's, like I mentioned, quite a lot more complicated. So the principle is kind of the same, though as you can see, I got myself a lot more dense cabling here. So let me just get started from the very beginning to demonstrate what I mean by this. So first of all, we got ourselves an ME controller right here. This is the main heart of the network. This is where all the channels, including these ones, are put into and pass through into each other. So this is the actual main heart. Keep that in mind. Connected to that, I got myself 5 different colors of ME dense cables. This is purely for aesthetical purpose, so it's easier to pretty much separate what you got connected to what line. Pretty cool. And to add to that, I got myself some P2P tunnels. One P2P tunnel per dense cable line, as a P2P tunnel can only transfer 32 channels at once. Like I said in the previous one, I also need a way to pass through power, either by hooking up an energy acceptor on the, well, pretty much the separate side of the PDP tunnel. So pretty much consider this as the first stage, very small. Then the ME smart cables that I dyed black is the second stage, so pretty much the pass-through line, which is, if I were to, you know, demonstrate it right here, can be considered as this red line that I got running right here. Then, because it's a little bit different when you use it directly with a dense cable line, and it won't exactly work normally, I had to put myself an ME controller in between this. Pretty much the reason to do this is that all these channels coming into this will be compacted using the ME controller, pretty much thinking that this is a separate network that can transfer 32 channels on each side, be split out into other PDP tunnels that I connected right here. Then on the other side, which is again, if you were to consider it the blue side, so it starts off with blue, sends over to red, which is in this case the black line, and then it gets sent back to the blue line, which is in this case all of these five different colors. Of course, you might already ask, like, okay, what on earth is the point of doing this way too complicated? And that's a very good question, because in a small scale like this, it doesn't really have a use. But the cool thing about this is that if you were to think about it a little bit more, is that using this one ME smart cable, I'm able to transfer, in this case, 32 times 5, being 160-something-something, channels all through one smart cable line, pretty much due to the fact that I got it compacted into the PDP tunnel and then hooked up to right here. Of course, I also hooked up these PDP tunnels right here to the PDP tunnels on the same side, so pretty much this white line and PDP tunnel is connected to this one, and then they both need power. So this one requires power from wherever you're able to get it from, and this subline also needs power from, in this case, the main line. So I know this is a very complicated situation, and yeah, I just definitely hope you guys will understand it a little bit more after this video, and be able to use it yourself in your own world. Because pretty much what this will now require me to have in your regular world is that instead of having to run like five bundles of dense cables all across your base to achieve these channels that you get from these five dense cabling, you only need to run one smart cabling and a P2P tunnel. So in the long run, if you have a base with like hundreds of blocks wide, this will save you a lot of resources, space, and just, you know, be a lot more efficient in general. And of course, like I mentioned, this will still talk to each other. So I got myself another ME drive set up right here on the yellow line, being this one, coming into the ME controller right here. Then again, being able to talk to the dense cable that I got hooked up right here, being compacted right here, being uncompacted again right here. And then the crafting terminal is able to talk to the same ME controller, which is hooked up to that drive. So anything that I put in here will be sent on this line, be compacted, sent into the ME controller. ME controller will find a place to put it, send it to this cable, recompact it, uncompact it, and put it into the ME drive. So yes, that is pretty much the concept of the P2P ME bus. Pretty awesome if you ask me. So I definitely hope you guys found this very educational. Honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if you guys still have a couple of questions for me afterwards. If you have, feel free to let me know down in the comment section. I am more than welcome to answer it, as this is a very complicated subject, especially for those that aren't too advanced with light energistics too. So yeah, pretty awesome. Be sure to like, comment and subscribe, and I will hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.